Welcome back to another episode of Gran Jacaimito in the Pedroche Valley of Andalusia, Spain.
So, here I am in our zone B. The area over there is going to be a horse arena and things for people who would like to stay here for a while. And so some sort of tourism. And here is something I'd like to show you. So, the horses have been here and they have heavily manured on top of the spent straw. They used to eat here. And over there, there they are. And with the rain and the hail that we had, all this material gets washed away and disintegrates a little bit more and basically composts. And the end result is then something like what we can see here. And I think that's a good thing, because this is now food for plants. And I'm very happy to see how this works. Of course, it would be nicer that it would not wash away, but the plan is there where you see the big brown spot, there will be an animal pathway for pigs. And there where the straw is, there we will have a few corrals for the sows and the piglets. This is something that we are going to start over winter. It will not be perfect in the beginning, but at least we intend to fence off this whole area with the sheep gone or elsewhere. And then we will have structures here, and at the end the material will not wash to the left, but instead stay here, because this will be the area where the sows can give birth to their litter, and we have more control, and it's very close to the house, now the compound right there, so that's going to be pretty easy. And the other thing that I wanted to show you is, you see here a lot of small green acorns. That is the result of the hail. So in many of the trees, the load of acorns that were growing is now gone. And if we were planning to do Montanera this time, we would be in trouble. And I just learned that other people who really depend on acorns and the fattening of the pigs with acorns, they're actually buying acorns from somewhere else if they don't have enough themselves. And I even heard a price, something like 40 cents per kilo of acorns that someone collects somewhere where they didn't have the hailstorm and don't run pigs. Because if you don't fatten them with acorns, then it's not jamón de bellota. And then it's not the real thing. So that is their solution. But we don't want to do this year. We focus on infrastructure and the cows and getting the rotation and the chicken going and all that. So we don't have any time for running pigs. They are much harder to control. But we will have a few for personal consumptions and to continue the work in this area here. And the goal is to have also the infrastructure required by the government to actually breed pigs. And then we will be in the pig business for real. So the pigs that we had, it's basically for learning so that we know what it entails. Now we do. And now we can take this into account for planning. And as I'm walking around here, I can go over to this area and I see a lot of green grass coming up. Let me zoom in. Hopefully you can now see better how it's coming. It's not evenly distributed, but there are some spots where the leaves are longer, while in others it's other things that are coming up. And I would think that is mostly clover or maybe something else, but I think it is a lot of clover that we have in the other parts. The green part there closer to the house, that is also regular grass. But I think I already filmed it. So there's another update from after the rain. A few days back, I was standing here showing you how the neighbor with the tractor down here had cut down the grass and basically mulched. And now, with the rain, a lot of green has shown up. So this is working out very well for him. And let me step in a little bit. Right here, you can already see there is a lot of new growth coming up. And the last time I mentioned, he was running some sheep here. And they added some manure. And because this is all fresh grass, so last year he seeded. Actually, the year before, and then last spring, he had the very high growing oats, and later he had grasses, and it's the very same grasses that are now coming up again. So he had used his tractor and the appropriate technique to put out pasture here, and it's working out very well for him. So in our case, we're basically doing the same. The only difference is he first tilled and destroyed everything, and then he put out the seed, let it grow, used a little bit the animals, and now he has pasture here, and I'm pretty sure that this will grow very well. While in our case, without a tractor, we are trying to restore the soil and also the plants without tilling it and turning everything around and destroying what we already have. So this basically is new, while in our case it's more a restoration project. At least that is how I see it. But from a commercial perspective, doing that is absolutely fine. The only thing that I'm worried about is what about the mycorrhizal fungi, because they are not there, because the tillage destroyed it. At least that is what I understand. You guys will tell me whether I see this right. Actually, I came across a video today where an organization here in Spain, next to us in Almeria, where they are doing some regenerative agriculture to restore the land on a plateau and other areas there. They had a video in Spanish talking about mycorrhizal fungi, and at some school they established a nursery for native plants of the area that are inoculated, because they were saying it doesn't make sense to bring in the fungi from elsewhere, because that fungi does not yet know, so to say, the other plants it should bond with. Makes sense to me. And we probably should do the very same thing when we get around to having our own nursery, because we need a lot more trees and shrubs and all that. So this is not wrong. It definitely provides some result. But the other thing is to do proper animal management. And as this person from here will help us with our zone CT1, where currently we have the pigs and the cows, he will plow this or till this the same way as he did here and establish the very same mix of plants. And then there's enough opportunity to compare notes. And maybe we will then be able to also compare the performance. This place here, the way he knows how to manage it, and our zone up there, where the conditions basically are pretty much the same, but the management will be different. So this will be an interesting conversation. I'll let you guys know how it goes. Isn't that impressive? That is the area at the entrance of our zone C, where the cows usually stay when they drink water. There is the waterer. And with the rain and all the manure and the straw that we also had here at some point, there is a lot of new plants. And I don't know what it is. We will learn this in a little while. But it is very impressive how this looks like. So it's like it were seeded. So this is all the stuff that is somehow in the soil and has now woken up. Makes for a very happy sight. And if I go over here to the actual paddock, this is also coming along, but it's less impressive than outside. You can see the difference. It appears that it wasn't the best idea to keep the whole herd together while they are confined to eat straw over the summer, because it seems that the older cows did not allow the young ones to actually eat enough. So they have lost quite a bit of weight, and apparently that was because of that. So now we separated them, and we are now keeping them for a couple of days or weeks here in this area. We have closed the path for the horses. They can eat another place. They are somewhere there you see a horse, so they won't get here. They also have a waterer. And now for the calves, we have this area so that they gain a little bit of weight. I will go this afternoon also to buy some supplemental feed so that they gain a bit weight faster, because the straw is not that rich in nutrients, obviously. So we are learning how to do this right, and apparently we didn't. So that is our learning experience. They wander around and look for things that are green. Of course, there isn't that much because the sheep are also here, but at least now we have this under control and I can see it, what is going on, because right there is my office, and when I do my IT work, I can frequently look out the window and see what is going on here in this area. And then they should be fine. The colophonia trees suffered a little bit from the hail, but it looks like that the damage is not too bad, because there's enough leaf, so they should continue to grow. So this is the one that lost the leaf because of the sheep earlier on, and it's looking fine. I don't think that this will be any problem. And the calves are up there, they're eating something green, which is good. So they should also be fine. Their manure isn't looking that bad. So I would assume they have lost weight because the older ones kicked them aside. And that is unfortunately, because they are their daughters. But apparently that's not important in a cow herd. And of course, in a natural setting, there would be grass all over the place. So it doesn't really matter. If you get kicked aside, well, then you move aside and you continue to eat elsewhere. But if there's only one place where you can eat, or the space is limited, then you might end up at the edge, and then there is not enough feed for you. So now it needs the human to get this better organized. So they're a little bit slim, but they do have their belly full, So it's not the material, it's also something else. So some supplemental feed that I will provide them now in the afternoon. That should do it. And it seems to be working better. But of course it's just been 24 hours. But at least there's nobody disturbing them or taking their food away or kicking them out. So they should gain a little bit more weight. But then of course the dogs here and there, and it's always the two females, are barking at them. But apparently they are used to this by now. The same is with the horses. The dogs like nobody near their compound. And the two females are very protective. Looks like this plant here is attractive for bees. I see a lot of them swirling around, and apparently they find food there. This plant shows up frequently here. There were pigs in this area in the past, and I believe it's some sort of amaranthus. So where it does not disturb anything, I let it grow. Of course, this is going to be in the future the dog enclosure, but there is no harm in having this grow and improve the soil, because later on the dogs can enjoy the grass that will eventually come up in this area as well. And I had to cut it down a little bit there to make some room for the Paulownias, but where it does not disturb, I just let it grow. Looks like after the hail, the remaining watermelon plants don't look that good. The good thing is we harvested all the watermelons that were there. When I loop around, I will see what the one, I see it already there. See? There, what the remaining one that was in development is doing. And there we can see it. So nothing bad happened apparently. But the rest of the plants, they look like they have suffered a little bit from that bombardment. But maybe they will recover. But then now we are at the end of September almost. So let's not expect too much from this. And like I said the last time that I was here, my plan is to just observe, do nothing, and let's see what happens to these plants. So if they die off, oh, here's another melon developing, which is great. So if they just die off over winter, it's fine. So nothing to do. And then we have more biomass. So the idea is harvest and do nothing. And now I'm going to feed the cat over there. I have the bag here. And she's already signaling that she's hungry. So we moved this in here, and it's a good reason for coming here and check out this wannabe food forest. So this is the pond by accident in the back part of our zone B. I just needed some soil for other places, and basically made this little wall here. The water comes from over there where the sheep are, and it's water that leaves our zone C, passes through the neighbor, only a few meters there, and then it ends up here. And there's also an overflow from the pond that the neighbor has up there. And it accumulates here. And with the little rain that we had, this thing filled up completely, which is good. So that indicates that we can certainly make it a little bit wider to have more impact on the surrounding land here. We do have a plan to fence off this area so that there where the animals have already created the path, that this is their path. And then we built the fence around the tree, so on the right side. And basically, or maybe we should enclose the temporary creek here in the path. But the idea is that the area to the left will become a paddock for the animals that we keep for any reason here in Zone B. Also, this is mostly for other things. But we can have a pond here and have a little paddock and use the area where the sheep are right now and the horse you see there in the background. Like I keep saying, this is going to be for pigs. It's a special system. You probably will see some of it by spring. And here we can make this a little bit wider and also remove the dirt piles over there and use this area for water retention. And we might actually pump it out and irrigate over there in that area, but I don't think that is something we will do. But a water feature, and could be nice, and maybe we get some ducks or something like that, and we can keep them here in this area. That could be a nice addition. But for now, this is the place where we get dirt when we need some, and over time this will become a little bit wider and also deeper. It's not very deep, it's maybe 1.50 meters deep. So this is this afternoon's mulching session. I cut down with the machete a few of those vetiver plants, and I placed the cut leaves here between the trees so that when more rain comes, this will decompose and then eventually build soil. And a little while, it's basically my weekend show, I will take care of this and place it down here to fill also this area so that later on we can plant some more trees here. And here, where I did this before, you can already see what is happening. And I like what I see. This should attract bacteria, microbes and all that. And the vetiver will regrow once summer comes around and the temperatures begin to rise again. So for now, this is simply mulching material. And it's exactly as was planned. And we just need to plant more of it so that we can have the material closer to the trees. And then just mulch and mulch and mulch and build soil.
That was the update for the last few days at the end of September 2021. In the remaining part of our 45 hectares, not much got caught on video, as the work being done is mostly related to repairing electric fencing. However, I can show you the latest addition. We leave the sheep mostly alone, and once in a while a new one shows up. I've said before that we want to remove these sheep, as they will be in the way of building infrastructure for pigs, which will limit their access to forage. The idea now is to remove the rams, and let the females be for the moment. That will get us down to 4 instead of 9, and the 4 will not eat that much that it matters. Please come back to Gran Hagamito in a couple of days and see how our journey continues. Thank you for watching.